Hello, Lakers Nation. Trevor Lane here, senior writer for LakersNation.com, and this is the Lakers Nation news feed, your home for breaking Lakers news. Today, we're going to be talking all about the Lakers' latest addition, Avery Bradley, pivoting pretty nicely from a tough situation with Kawhi Leonard, watching him walk to the Los Angeles Clippers. Now, the Lakers have managed to pivot and land a number of solid players, and Avery Bradley is just another example of that. We're going to dive into it in just a moment, but first, quick shout-out to our sponsor, BetOnline.ag. All you have to do is head over to clnsmedia.com/LeBron, punch in the promo code CLNS50, and you'll get a 50% bonus on your first deposit. So ESPN's Adrian Wojnarowski reported that Avery Bradley, once he clears waivers, he was released by the Memphis Grizzlies, plans to sign a two-year, $9.7 million deal with the Los Angeles Lakers. So in terms of the cap situation, that is the room exception. The room exception was the money that the Lakers had left over. They've spent all their cap space. Now they've spent the room exception. They have nothing left but veteran minimum deals. I'm already getting a lot of people asking, well, what about Andre Iguodala? He's been rumored to be linked to the Lakers if he eventually secures a buyout also from the Grizzlies. They can still get him. They can still get Andre Iguodala. They can still get Kyle Korver. I would expect them to land another small forward, a true small forward, because Avery Bradley is more of a two than a three. If you look at their depth chart, they really have LeBron and then not a lot else if you're factoring in Jared Dudley as more of a power forward at this stage in his career, which is certainly how I see him. So yes, they can still land a Kyle Korver, can still land a Andre Iguodala. They just have to do it at a minimum deal. That's the only option the Lakers have left. Now, in terms of Bradley, what are they getting? You're getting a guy who is a very, very solid defender. In fact, was known as one of the better defensive guards in the league not too long ago, but had a little bit of a bumpy season last year with the Clippers, picked things up when he went over to the Memphis Grizzlies, had a really nice finish to last season. But at 28 years old, he's in his prime. He's a 36% career shooter from three, which isn't fantastic, but it's certainly good enough, passable, to where you have to go out there, you have to cover him from behind the three-point line, and he should see a number of open looks playing alongside guys like LeBron James and Anthony Davis. But he's really known for his defense. He can really lock in on guys on the defensive end, and that's certainly something that the Lakers could use. Should be an interesting battle now for the backup shooting guard spot. Danny Green will certainly slot into the starting spot, but behind him, the fight between Kentavious Caldwell-Pope and Avery Bradley for the backup minutes should be a real good one, and one to certainly keep an eye on. All right, guys, for more on this and everything else going on in the world of the Los Angeles Lakers, make sure you head over to LakersNation.com and keep it tuned right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. And of course, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.